Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.2, Problem 1. This is Section 10.2, Problem Number 1. It says, Fastball Frankie is a pitcher on a popular baseball team. He has an average fastball speed of mu equal to 96.2 miles per hour with a standard deviation of sigma equal to 1.2 miles per hour. The pitching coach puts Frankie on a weight training program to make him pitch even faster. A sample of 36 fastball pitches has an average speed of x bar equal to 96.6 miles per hour. Use a hypothesis test to test the pitching coach's claim that Frankie's fastball speed has increased. Use a 5% level of significance. So this is a hypothesis test. There's a six-step process. In this type of test, we happen to know what the population standard deviation is. Sometimes you don't know, and it's going to be a little bit different. So six steps. Step one, state the null hypothesis. So the null hypothesis will have some information about mu. And it'll contain the condition of equality. State the null hypothesis. H sub 0, mu equals 96.2. That's step one, state the null hypothesis. And the null always has equality in it. So it could be like a greater than or equal to, but it'll have equal to in it one way or the other. Step two, state the alternate hypothesis, H sub 1. Some books use H sub A, but H sub 1 is a little bit more common. Mu, same mu, it's going to have 96.2 again. But now there's going to be a symbol here. It will be an inequality symbol. Now you have to ask yourself, are you looking for greater than or less than? And occasionally it's not equal to for a two-tailed test. In this case, we're testing the claim that the average speed of his fastball is even more than it used to be, that he can pitch even faster now, so that it's greater than, his average is greater than it used to be. That's what we're testing, that he can pitch even faster. That's the second step, state your alternate hypothesis. The third step is determine if it's a left-tail, right-tail, or two-tail test. So to determine what type of test, look at the inequality symbol in your alternate hypothesis and see which direction it's pointing in. In this case, we have a greater than symbol in our alternate hypothesis. It points to the right. So this is a right tail test. Step three, calculate that formula z equals, so it's going to be z equals x bar minus mu over sigma divided by the square root of n. That's step four to calculate that. Now let's plug in the values that we know. Z equals x bar. Well, it says in the problem, x bar is 96.6 minus mu. Mu is given as 96.2. So we can see that the new sample is faster. It's only a little bit faster, but statistically speaking, is that enough evidence to say that Frankie really pitches faster now? Or were those 30 pitches just coincidentally faster? That's what this is going to determine. So now sigma underneath, the standard deviation for the population, is 1.2 divided by square root of n. N is the size of the sample. Our sample has a size 36. That's n. Don't forget the square root. Fairly common mistake. So that's what we have to compute. Now, let's work that down. In the numerator, I can do 96.6 minus 96.2. That's going to give me a 0.4, positive 0.4. You have to pay attention to the sign. Sometimes it's negative. In this case, positive. 1.2 divided by, let me get rid of that square root. Square root of 36 is 6, because 6 times 6 is 36. And then that fraction underneath, 1.2 divided by 6. So the top will stay 0.4. Think of it briefly as 12 over 6 is 2, but because 1.2 are not actually a 12, it's 0.2. Or you could just use a calculator. Then I have 0.4 divided by 0.2. You can either let the decimals cancel out. I can see the answer is 2. Or you can use your calculator, 0.4 divided by 0.2 equals, and it'll tell you that it's 2. So step 4 was to do this computation, which we did. We took the formula, filled in the numbers from the explanation, and got an answer of 2. That's step 4. Step 5 is look up the answer that you got from your computation. So we are going to look up 2 in that standard normal chart, the chart with the z values, because this is a z that we computed. So now, to look up a value of 2, first you have to write it so that it has 2 places after the decimal. You don't want just 2, you want to write it as 2.00. You have to have 2 places after the decimal. Next, what you do is split the number you want to look up by pulling off the rightmost digit. So that rightmost zero is going to come off. So I have 2.0 and then the zero, the rightmost digit, comes off to the side. After that, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now what I want to do is the digits from the left, the 2.0, that's going to tell me what row of that standard normal chart I want to look in. The digit from the right with the 0.0 in front tells me what column of the standard normal chart I want to look in. And now if you intersect the 2.0 row with the 0.00 column, it intersects at 0.9772. Again, you want to make sure you're in the positive part of the chart. Remember, the chart has a positive page and a negative page. So this is positive 2. You want to look in the positive page. So step 5 is look up the number you got from your computation. We looked it up. The result we got is 0.9772. Step 6, the final step, is state your conclusion. So we are testing at a 5% level of significance. So this involves our bell curve, or our normal curve. Now, 5% level of significance, and we have a right tail test, is telling us on the right tail, if you get into the rightmost 0.05, you're going to reject the null hypothesis. And if there's 0.05 on the far right, and the whole thing's 100%, there's 0.95 that's not out in the critical tail. So now when we look up the 2.00, we get 0.97. We've gone a little past the 0.95. So we are in that critical area, which means when you get into the critical area, the conclusion is to reject the null hypothesis. Now, the wording you want to use is reject the null hypothesis. You don't want to actually say accept the alternate hypothesis, which almost kind of means the same thing, but to control that level of significance and how likely it is that you've made the wrong choice, you want to word it either reject the null hypothesis or fail to reject the null hypothesis. So we reject the null hypothesis. That's our conclusion. Or you could just put H sub 0, which means that it's very likely that Fastball Frankie can pitch even faster now than he used to be able to pitch. Based on that one sample of 36 pitches, because of this process, it wasn't just coincidental that it was a little bit faster. There's enough evidence to say most likely he can pitch even faster than he used to.